Todoist is a powerful task management application, and in the last 12 months, it's added calendars and team workspaces, some powerful features to help you get more things done. But is it worth it for you in 2024? Let's dive into it in today's video. Welcome, my name is Francesco. I'm going to be taking you through this Todoist review, helping you work out whether it's right for you. There will be deals below in the description, and if you want to join Toolfinder, you'll find insights, reviews, and lots more as we grow our platform for helping you find tools for work and life. So I think the best starting point with Todoist is to start with pricing. Todoist comes with three main pricings. There's beginner, pro, and business. The beginner pricing is free, and it comes with 5 personal projects, as well as the board view as well. There are some limitations to that, like 3 filtered views and a few more, and obviously this is subject to change. But the premium pricing gives you it at $4 per user per month billed annually, which allows you to access up to 400 personal projects, and most importantly, gives you access to calendar layout and task reminders, which is a big thing for a lot of people. There's also a business pricing, which allows you to access the shared team workspace at $6 per user per month. There's a bunch of other administration things like centralized billing, team roles and permissions that you might get access to. Now, as I said, Todoist is very simply a task management application. It allows you to add a task, add recurring due dates, even reminders as well in the premium, and use natural language to quickly capture tasks. One of the best things about this app is the quick capture, allowing you to do it on such a range of devices, because Todoist is available on pretty much all major devices. It also comes with Siri, Alexa, and Google Home integration if you want to capture stuff fast. Now, inside of Todoist, you can add tasks to your inbox, which is a perfect place to capture, but there's also a today area for organizing what you can plan for the day ahead. You can even break this down into certain layouts as well, including the more recently launched calendar view, which is currently in beta, but probably set to roll out by the time we post this video. Now, this experience is great for planning what you need to do for the day, but what if you want to plan ahead? Well, the upcoming view comes with a board and a calendar layout, as well as a list view, which helps you to connect with Google Calendar to see your events and your tasks in real time and see what you want to focus on for the day and week ahead. This is perfect for organizing overdue tasks as well, and you can use a system called time blocking to actually add tasks into your time, and this is great for visual thinkers. Now, each of your tasks in Todoist is organized into projects, and maybe since last time you checked out Todoist, they've added this calendar view to the projects area, which is great for organizing and planning out your tasks for the week ahead. It also will help you to manage it in board view, allowing you to add sections and even customize it even further with custom view in the top right hand corner, which will allow you to even further break down the tasks into an order that you find most suitable, like priority first or even a due date first, to help you decipher what is and what is most important to focus on. Now, there are filters and labels which are used by the more advanced individuals, which will allow you to break down some of the tasks into more detail. But typically for the average user, this is pretty much available through the custom views ability. And also there's a templates area which you can browse templates and copy them into your workspace. And naturally, you can find ones from pretty cool people out in the world. Now, each of the projects for the team experience is shared. So, for example, you could invite a few of your friends to a project, but largely this has come under the paid experience. This will allow you to share and assign tasks, leave comments to people as well. But most importantly, if you've got a team workspace and you're using it collaboratively, this is perfect for those who want to use it in a team. Small businesses will find this great. There's analytics to see what people are working on, and also a great way to collaborate and share stuff with other people. There is additional abilities like Todoist Karma, which allows you to set a daily target for your work and a weekly focus so that you can see how much you completed as you've gone across a day per project that you're working on. This is great for visualizing some of the work that you're doing. Now, it's really strange because Todoist is one of these apps that is so straightforward that anyone can use it, but has advanced features too tucked underneath that will allow you to do a lot more. Now, the pros and cons of this application are, as I said, it's straightforward. I could recommend this to my mother-in-law, but also to an advanced user who wants to get more done, say GTD. But also it has some really reliable and also powerful applications that's part of its network. The application has also been around for, I believe, over 12 years, 13 years now, which is a really long time. And the company are really credible and well put together in terms of how they market themselves and their ethos as a company. Now, the application does have some cons to it. Obviously, reminders is something that's locked under the premium, which for some people is a bit of a killer. Reminders are great for setting a reminder before a task, but it also has location reminders for when you arrive at a certain place that you set. And this is great for those who are using it in a more straightforward manner. Calendar view is also locked under premium, which is a bit of a shame, but as you can imagine, this is how Todoist are probably making their money. Other applications in the market, like Motion, AccuFlow, and Sensama, are four times the pricing with their calendar abilities. Obviously, they do have some different features, but this is something to note, so you're probably getting a good deal even with the premium experience. So largely, Todoist is a popular application. It's been downloaded 30 million times, and that's for a reason. The application's really good at bringing together all of the way that you manage your tasks, and it focuses brilliantly on that task management aspect of things. With the more recent time blocking abilities, you get more done, but as a whole, Todoist has impressed me and will probably impress you if you're looking for something basic, really well priced in terms of value, and everything else as you can imagine. Thank you very much for tuning into this Todoist review. As I said, if you're interested, you can join Toolfinder below and you'll get automatically added to our newsletter, which will help you to find deals and resources for productivity software and tools, or software for work and life. Thank you very much for watching, and if you did enjoy it, hit like, subscribe, and we'll see you again in a future video. Cheerio!